fairy tales, love inspires you to be noble and courageous, but in real life, love is just an all-purpose excuse for selfish behavior.
I don't know if you are actually cynical or just a super crazy romantic cheese ball.
I know it's probably an easy comparison, but I think people see this as being a very modern, hip version of something like When Harry Met Sally.
Great. We're very happy with that. That's, you know, it's interesting because I think the central questions that both films ask are actually quite different.
Yeah.
But I think that because the word friends is mentioned in both, yes, that they sort of get slammed together. Yeah. But also, very happy to be compared to one of the sort of undisputed great romantic comedies of all time. Like, that's, we're all happy with that. We're not going to shirk that comparison. But I do think that, you know, when Harry Met Sally asked, can men and women really be friends? The question asked by What If is more, is it ever sane or healthy to deny your own feelings for somebody?
Friends?
Yeah, why not?
All right.
Friends. Is this always how you make friends? Like, it's a business deal?
Yeah, actually, it's just my style.
Okay, it's quite unnerving.
Because Wallace is somebody who realizes that he's in love with her, Chantry, at the beginning of the movie, realizes he can't have her, and so just kind of settles for, like, well, you know what? Even though it'll kill me, those moments of happiness that I get from being around you are worth it. And he kind of makes that decision. And that's, you know, that's torturous, you know, and it's hard. And in the end, obviously, he's very grateful that he made that decision. But I do think if I was in that position, I would be a lot more direct about it. Like, I can't live in uncertainty like he does.
Seeing you in a role like this, which was quite different, I started thinking, is this actually more like you?
Yeah, it's much more like me than it's much more like me than Harry was, I think, because people have seen me play Harry for so long.
Yeah.
They sort of think that's who I'm most like, but actually, like, I'm much more like Wallace than I am probably any other part that I've played, really. I hope other people enjoy that as well. I hope people like seeing, I mean, it's not, I am different from this character, we're not the same person, but in terms of how we relate to people and our sense of humour, I think I'm very similar to him. Yeah.
And there's a lovely chemistry there too. And
cool.
I mean, was there a lot of improvisation? I mean, were you really?
In this scene, there was quite a bit of improvisation, actually.
Yeah.
In the first scene in the diner, and there was a few other moments in it. What we would normally do is we do three or four takes that were completely as scripted, and then we do some that were just like, do whatever you want, go crazy. And they were great fun. But we also had the advantage of having the writer on set for almost the entire movie, which you very rarely do.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you were ever unsure about something, you just ad-libbed, you could go up to him and be like, was that all right? Was that all right?
100% honesty is the foundation of any relationship.
Whoa, you are 100% honest with Nicole?
Yes.
About everything?
Yep.
What, New Orleans 2006? What was her name? Favia? Yeah, she did look like a woman, to be fair.
But the person who I say does the most improvisation in the film is Adam Driver. It might not surprise you to know. Like,
yeah,
half
right.
of what, I'd say like, half of the things that come out of his mouth, I feel like, were just, particularly my favorite one was he's shouting at a guy playing bowls, like an old man, and he says, you couldn't find that stone if it was in your kidney. I was just like, he made it up, and it was like, that's very good.
There's a very iconic kind of sandwich in here for you.
Yes.
Which I guess is a favorite of Elvis, right?
It was, apparently. It's like slightly less famous than his deep fried banana sandwiches, was Fool's Gold. And he is alleged to have, like, when you see a thing of Fool's Gold, it's a loaf of Italian white bread coated in butter, you hollow out the inside, fill it with half a jam of peanut butter, half a jar of jam, and then stuff it with a pound of crispy bacon, and then bake the whole thing. I loved it.
Did you actually ate it?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I had. It's hard to decide what I enjoyed more, like eating my four pieces or watching Zoe eat her one, because she hated it. Like, she was very much like, okay, chew, 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 and can I have something to spit this into, please? Like, it wasn't, like, I was just thinking, we've landed ourselves a job where we get paid for eating this sandwich. How are you not loving this? But no, it's one of the only things we differ on, really.
There's a scene where you go and see Princess Bride. Is there a film in your own life that would be like the film that you would go back and see many times?
If there was a screening of Arthur in a movie theater with Dudley Moore and Liza Minnelli, John Gielgud, I would be at that in a second.
Really?
Like, I would love to see that film in a movie theater again. Like, I would take all my friends. I love that film.